Hi, Chris Chinoff for Insight Media, Display Week 23 in the Vitrealab booth in the iZone. Vitrealab has developed a very interesting light source. They originally started development to create basically a display using their light source, but they kind of pivoted now as kind of an illuminator for AR and VR applications. So what they do is they start with single mode red, green, and blue lasers, and they put it into a device. This is what their key invention is. This is what they call their quantum light chip. And as you can see on this this diagram here, they take these single mode fibers and they put it into this material that is basically a number of waveguides that fan out these RGB and spread them out uniformly over the area. But then to extract the light in this vertical direction, they put a nanostructure on the deck side, which is basically a mirror and collimator for each of these beams. There's about 10,000 beams that they can create from an illuminator like this. Because it's lasers and because they work on collimation, you can get a very controlled emission spectrum from this, as I say, 10 degree field of view versus 180 degree emission from LEDs. So in addition, you know, you've got the benefits of lasers, which is, you know, the higher efficiency, the higher brightness, and the potentially the wider color gamut if that's of interest. They're showing two demos this year. One is a VR demo, which they're showing over here. Interestingly, 10,000 nits. I'm not going to point the camera down the barrel here, but take my word for it, it's a little bright. But you'll also notice they've got four knobs here. Well, these knobs are zones. Yeah, think about that. So you've got an illumination source. This can be basically zone dimmed as well to create potentially an interesting HDR image. So this is 10,000 nits right now. On the roadmap is to make that go to 100,000 nits. Do you need 100,000 nits for VR? Well, maybe you do, actually, because if you're using pancake optics, for example, then that's 10% efficient. If you go to a 10% duty cycle for motion compensation, then those numbers go up rather quickly. Over here, they're showing their AR demo. In this case, they are basically replace the LED illuminator with the laser and quantum chip to provide the light to the LCOS device, again coupled into a waveguide here. The waveguide is not their technology. It's the illuminator for the LCOS engine. Chris Chinoff here for Insight Media.